seeing different parts of the planet in such a short period of time is hard to digest. It makes me wonder sometimes how one person can endure so much information at once. It's like an exercise at this point. I'm so used to hardly ever sleeping and roaming the streets of downtown Toronto with no care and motives in life. Little did I know it helped create this character of my songs that I left behind the first day I became known for my music. And it's probably for the best too. I'd be lying if I didn't miss it a little bit though. But I'm glad I could grow and be something I've only dreamed of being. I always told myself if I could be successful coming from where I came from, then I could do anything. I can't recall the last time I stayed in my hometown for more than 2 weeks. I've grown accustomed to hotels and drastic climate change. Every day you see new faces and you can't help but forget how much time goes by. Especially when you're working on new music. When you're traveling constantly every day, you become inspired and it shows in my work sonically, lyrically, visually. Conversations with women with different accents and stories told in those accents. I like to create characters based on different people I've met and relationships. I like to tell stories loosely based on real life events. Touring really helped me become a better producer and songwriter. Seeing the reactions of the fans when I play certain songs, what area in the song they react well to. I take mental note of all that stuff. I always remember it and then I bring it into the studio. And I use it. What Trilogy was more of a claustrophobic body of work. Before it was released, I hadn't left my city for literally 21 years, and I had never been on a plane, not once. I spent my entire life in one setting. That's probably why pieces of the album feel like one long track. It's because that's what it felt like. It felt like one long song, and that's what my life felt like. Kissland is the story after Trilogy. It's pretty much the second chapter in my life. The narrative in the album, it all takes place after my first flight. And it's very foreign. The artistic concept is foreign and very Asian inspired. Dig into different universes and in music and different generations. It helps me create a sort of melancholy R&B and alternative soul music with very honest and disturbing truths. What young men think but will never say out loud. I've learned to pretty much just not give a shit, and it kind of morphed this sound, and it works. I enjoy making it. There's nothing else I'd rather do. When people ask me why Japan, I simply tell them because it's the furthest I've ever been from home. It really is a different planet. There's a certain order that almost haunts Tokyo. I find it beautiful. It's just so different. You can't smoke outside, and they take littering very seriously. Nobody seems to talk to strangers. Couples don't kiss in public or even hold hands. It's really refreshing. And me, I just felt like a contrast walking the streets. But it helped me create a world. It helped mold the concept for the album. Kissland symbolizes the outside world and the world that surrounds the trilogy world. It tells the story of me coming back home and dealing with what I left behind. All the videos from Trilogy were more or less directed by me. Because I'm such an avid film watcher, my music has such a cinematic influence. For Kissland, I came up with a lot of cool visual ideas, but I left all the directing to the professionals. I really wanted to execute my vision and bring it to life. I look at Trilogy as a learning experience, and it makes it easier for me and the director to get the shots we intended.
Nobody's ever made me find out when this amount of time. like, I'm gonna follow you on this one, it doesn't matter. So let me just take a step in.
Towards you?
Yeah. No. Take a step down. Take a step to the middle, there.
I know how it feels to be behind the camera and get those shots you want. And it really is rewarding when you do get them. The writing style is more or less an evolution. I've learned to take more care in how I say things as opposed to being cavalier. The production is pretty much me asking myself constantly, did I do this, or have I used this formula before? Have I used similar sounds, or have I done this arrangement before? But this is also the longest I've ever spent on a project since House of Balloons. Thursday was pretty much a freestyle, or a subconscious singing, as I like to call it, and leftovers from House of Balloons, and Echoes of Silence was a mixture of both styles, but with a lot less time to work on it. I put out 3 albums in 1 year. That's 30 songs in 1 year, not to mention the album work I did on Take Care. Everybody thought it was too outlandish and too bold, but I wasn't trying to make a statement or anything. It's just the only thing I knew how to do. Make music, put it out, make music, put it out, make more music, and put more music out. I mean, it became a success. I was number 2 on the charts from music that was out for 2 years and repackaged into a deluxe album. There was an impact in the industry, and I see it being done again by bigger artists because it worked. I like making music. I'll always be making music, and I'll always reinvent myself and do things and say things other artists wouldn't do or say. I feel like my fans will love Kissland because I didn't change. It's the same character, but in different settings and scenarios. Once you change who you are or who you've portrayed in your music, the fans, they'll catch it. Once you try to convince yourself that the fans are stupid, then you lose. You belong to them, not the other way around. They choose your fate, and that's the truth. Once I feel like the world knows me for anything else but my music, then I feel like I fail. I try to shy away from press because it's never about the art for them. And I totally respect that. But the only thing I rely on is good music. I have no publicity stunts or any crazy interviews about how crazy my life is. Any impact I've had was from nothing but that. The world didn't have a face to put to the music until recently. And that's how I want to be remembered.